one, do this one right here. I'm going to go into what is coming. There's another cycle coming. The universal consciousness cycle. Again, I'm not kidding. Universal consciousness cycle. It begins on February 10th, 2011. During this consciousness cycle, each one of these shifts and changes will last for, or will take 20 days. Now remember 2 million years ago, we picked up this tool called the mind? Well, we're going to have a little bit of problem with that thing. And we don't want to talk about that right now. The mind. The mind is a tool. And it's a tool that consciousness uses to distinguish similarities and differences between things. Okay? It is a tool, like a hammer or a saw. People think that they are their mind. Get over that right away. You are not your mind or any of your thoughts. If you do hold to that, you're going to be in big trouble, and I'm going to show you. The mind works on a series of pictures. Well, special effects people know all about this. The flicker frequency. The flicker frequency is 24 frames per second. That's how fast your mind works. Your mind has a speed limit. Your mind can only think 24 thoughts in 1 second. It can only make this action 24 times per second. Consciousness is moving at least 5 billion decisions per second. You understand that consciousness is as fast as you can realize? So now we're talking about nanoseconds, which is 1/1000th of a second. 100,000th of a second. Wow. Consciousness has just sped away from your mind. Are you starting to get the impact of what this acceleration means? 400 years ago, people had lots of time to sit and ponder things before they changed. In 400 years, you had lots of 24th of a second to work it out. But now, it's not that way, and it's going to get faster and faster on everybody you know, including yourself. So now, it's pretty evident that we are all going to be going completely out of our minds. It's going to happen. So we might as well go ahead and look at what's out there outside of your mind. What's out there is your intuition. What is outside of your own mind is your intuition, your own personal knowing. Your own personal power. And having this engaged really puts the mind in its place, where it becomes just a tool rather than an identity. So, how do you do that? Well, intuition is your own personal knowing, right? And all knowing comes from a source. We don't have to give it a name even, it just comes from somewhere. And it comes in a flow, more or less. It's like a, this is
this. There we go.
We'll have this flow of creation. See, the source of this flow would necessarily be the source of all knowing, because it's all that happens is coming out, all that exists is coming this way. So, here we have your consciousness in this flow of event. Okay? Here we go. Like this, this, this. Oh boy, it's getting quicker and quicker and quicker and quicker and quicker. Your consciousness is oriented by time and place in this flow. This is the schematic of how this works. When you're in your intuition, you're centered in that flow of information. The trick is to stay there. It's not so easy with everything that's going on and with your mind preying on you. But the Maya had two things on this side. One, things were going slower, but they had a couple of other orientations. We are oriented, our consciousness and our society is oriented by time and place. Time and place, time and place. Physical, 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 physical. The Maya had some more help. They had this orientation right here, which is called personal intent. One through 13. Okay? They also had this orientation, this major orientation right here, called the divine plan.
And figure.
So this personal intent and this orientation to the divine plan, that is the recognition of your part in the divine plan, that produces a symbol in the Mayan civilization. This diagram right here has a name. It's called the 8-division sky place. And that symbol stands for heaven.